Hey everybody, I'm Rick Beato. So what is a drum groove and how does this video, Top 20 Drum Grooves of All Time, differ from my Top 20 intros, for example, or Top 20 drum fills? Well, the groove is actually the main beat of the song. We call it a groove, but you can call it a beat as well. The drum grooves that I decided to pick on this one are from all classic drummers, and they're beats that, or grooves that inspire drummers to come up with their own kind of grooves based on them. As a matter of fact, some of these are actually grooves that drummers based their grooves on ones that come after it. You'll see what I mean when we get to it, but some of these grooves are actually based on other grooves on the list. So helping me on this video are my good friends, and you've seen them both on my channel before, Jack Jones on the drums and Les Hall on the bass and some guitars and keyboards. As a matter of fact, we have a funny thing going on that they're in all of my biggest videos. So Les said, well, you can't do the video without me in it if Jack's going to be in it. So I said, all right, well, come down and be in the video then. So I'm going to count down my personal top 20 drum grooves. They're in all different genres. They're in rock, they're in funk, they're in soul, they're in fusion. But these are my top 20 drum grooves of all time. Coming in at number 20 is a song that's been featured on the channel many times, but I think part of it, besides the guitar riff, is the drum part that makes this song happen. Here it is. Song number 19 is off a record release in 1962, and the drummer is Al Jackson Jr. Here it is. Coming in at number 18 is a drum groove by one of my favorite drummers, Questlove. Here it is. Song number 17 is a drum groove off a song from a record that launched an entire new genre of music and radio format. Here it is. Song number 16 is by one of my favorite rock drummers. He always seems to appear on the list, and this is one of my favorite bands. Check it out. Song number 15 actually appeared in one of our other lists. I won't tell you which one, but this particular song and groove, actually I think it was from the keyboard intro list, but the drum groove is just as important. Check it out. Coming in at number 14 is a drummer that many people emulated. He plays what I call a lot of non-fills when he's filling, but his grooves are killer. Groove number 13 is off a record released in 1984. A lot of people say, why don't you have this guitarist on your channel more? Well, I will eventually have a dedicated video to him. Here it is. Song number 12 was released in 1969. This groove is unmistakable, and it's by my favorite band, so you know who the band is. Song number 11 is by the great Mitch Mitchell, and it's featured on one of my favorite Jimi Hendrix songs. Now we're down to the top 10. Coming in at number 10 is a song that many people question whether the kick drum in the beginning is actually played on drums or it's played on something else. The drum part is a double kick, very fast double kick part, and it has a swinging feel to it. The guitar part's also really hard to play. Check it out. Song number 9 is off a record released in 1972, and it's by the great Bill Withers. Coming in at number 8 is a song that was really hard to recreate. It's got a lot of syncopation, but it's a killer groove. Here it is. Song number 7 is the only odd time signature on the list, and it's actually not in 7, but it's by a drummer who's a very dear friend of mine. Check it out. Song number 6 is by a drummer that was in our top 20 drum intros, and this is actually not this groove that you think it is, but it is a Steve Gadd groove. Okay, now we're down to the top 5. Now, honestly, any of these could be in any order. I always say that, but that's actually probably not true for this list. The number 1, 2, and 3 are very, very iconic grooves and copied by everyone. But this particular one was released in 1969, and it's off the Meters' first album. Check it out. Song number 4 is by the great James Brown. You knew there had to be a James Brown Clyde Stubblefield groove on here, and there is. Here it is. Coming in at number 3, this song has actually been on a bunch of the top 20 lists. This groove was in the top 20 drum intros, and it's based on 2 of the next grooves that come after it. Check it out. Song number 2 is by a drummer that you knew was going to be on here. This particular groove is a shuffle, and it's based on the number 1 song on the list. Check it out. Coming in at number one is a drum groove off a record released in 1977 by Steely Dan entitled Asia. This particular groove was copied many times, including by the two previous drummers. They put their own spin on them, but this is actually the original one. Bernard Purdy's. Okay, many of you are going to say, Rick, forgot this one, you forgot that one, you forgot this one. Put your own list down. I want to see which ones you think I forgot. Maybe I'll make a second video on this because there are a lot of great drum grooves. This was very difficult to do. This was as impossible as some of the other lists, maybe even more difficult. I tried to look for things, though, that influenced other drummers. Not necessarily other styles, but other drummers. So I'd love to see your thoughts. Please leave them in the comments, give it a thumbs up, and don't forget. That's all for now. Don't forget to subscribe, ring the bell, and leave a comment. Check out my new Quick Lessons Pro guitar course that just came out. Also, the Beato book, if you want to learn about music theory, that's how you do it. And check out my Beato ear training course at beatoeartraining.com. And don't forget, if you want to support the channel even more, think about becoming a member of the Beato Club. Thanks so much for watching.